स्टूडेंट ओपन पेज नंबर 114. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द बुक एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ द चैप्टर. नाउ टेक आउट योर क्लास वर्क कॉपी. क्वेश्चन नंबर डी शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चंस. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. क्वेश्चन डी स्टूडेंट वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. हु गेव दिस स्लोगन गिव मी ब्लड एंड आई विल गिव यू फ्रीडम. सो स्टूडेंट द फेमस स्लोगन गिव मी ब्लड एंड आई विल गिव यू फ्रीडम वॉज गिवन बाई सुभाष चंद्र बोस. सो दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिटन इन आवर क्लास वर्क कॉपी. So let's start with the question number 2. What did Gandhiji do when he came back to India? What did Gandhiji do when he came back? To India. So student, I have already explained you in 1915 Gandhiji returned back from South Africa. And when Gandhiji come back to India, he traveled all over the country. Reason behind is that when he come back, Gandhiji traveled all over the country. What is the reason for that? Gandhiji thought that in this way he will able to understand the problems of the people of India, what problem they are facing under British rule, and he was very shocked to see the problems of the poor people of the country. And at that time there are many social evils are also in the society, and the position of the poor people, poor people they are suffering in the British rule. So student, Gandhiji decided that now he will fight against the British administration. Is it clear? So note down from the board. Then Gandhi ji When Gandhi ji came back to India, when Gandhi ji came back to India, he traveled all over the country. He traveled all over the country. He felt this would he felt this would help him help him understand the problems Understand the problems of the people. So he decided. So he decided to fight against the British. And also against the social and religious evils. Against the social Against the social and religious evils. So, student, when Gandhi ji come back to India, he traveled all over the country because in this manner he thought that he will understand the problems of the people in the British rule, and he was very surprised that the condition of the poor people, they are suffering from lot of problems at the time of British rule. And even Gandhi ji observed that there are many social evils are also in the society. Okay, social and religious evils are there in the society. He also observed this. So in the end, Gandhi ji decided to fight against the British rule also, and even against the social and religious evils विच आर प्रेजेंट एट दैट टाइम इन द सोसाइटी. ही डिसाइडेड टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश रूल ऑल्सो एंड ऑल्सो अगेंस्ट द सोशल एंड रिलीजियस इविल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द सोसाइटी एट दैट टाइम. नोट डाउन दिस आंसर और इवन यू कैन टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट ऑल्सो. नोट डाउन द थर्ड क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट. क्वेश्चन 3, व्हेन डिड गांधी जी लॉन्च द नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट. व्हेन डिड गांधी जी लॉन्च द नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट. सो स्टूडेंट, व्हेन डिड गांधी जी लॉन्च द नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट. सो स्टूडेंट, इन 1990 गांधी जी लॉन्च नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट ड्यू टू द इंसिडेंट हैपेंस इन जलियांवाला बाग. देयर इज ए रोलेक्ट एक्ट विच हैज बीन पास बाय द ब्रिटिश एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दैट नॉट मोर देन 5 पीपल्स कैन गैदर टुगेदर एंड इवन एट द टाइम ऑफ द फेस्टिवल्स. इंडियन, यू ऑल्सो नो दैट इंडिया इज ए लैंड ऑफ फेस्टिवल. इवन no gathering at the time of a festival also. So to attend the public meeting in Jallianwala Bagh in 13th April 1919, many of the peoples gathered in Jallianwala Bagh. So what the General Dyer officer, British officer General Dyer, he enter in that Jallianwala Bagh with his soldiers and there is only one entrance gate in that Jallianwala Bagh. And what he has done, he ordered his soldier to fire the peoples which gathered together to attend the public meeting. So after this incident in 1920, Gandhi ji launched a non-cooperation movement. And what was the agendas of this non-cooperation movement is that boycott of foraging goods. Many student of the colleges and schools, they don't attend the college and schools which are established by the British administration at that time, and even people start refusing whatever work is given to them by the British people. So in 1920, Gandhiji launched the non-cooperation movement. Note down. In 1920, Gandhiji launched launched the non corporation movement. So student, note down the answer, or you can also take a screenshot also. So student, we have completed question number 3 also. Now question number E, that is long answer question. Question number E, long answer question, student, you will write from the new page. Is it clear? Long answer question, you will write from the new page. So question number 1, what happened at Jallianwala Bagh? So this is your first question, what happened at Jallianwala Bagh? Note down the question. What happened at Jallianwala Bagh? So student, what happened there on April 13, 1919? Many people gathered in the Jallianwala Bagh, and where is it? Is it in Amritsar for the public meeting? So at that time, British government passed a new law that is known as a Rowlatt Act in 1919, according to which not more than 5 people will gather at any प्लेस. सो अ ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर हुज नेम इज जनरल डायर विद हिज शोल्डर कम टू द पार्क एंड ही ब्लॉक्ड द ओनली देर इज वन एंट्रेंस गेट इन दैट पार्क एंड आफ्टर दैट व्हाट हैपेंस स्टूडेंट ही ऑर्डर्ड हिज सोल्जर टू फायर एट द क्राउड. हंड्रेड ऑफ मैन वुमेन चिल्ड्रन वर किल्डेड वाइल थाउजेंड वर इंजर्ड. ओके सो इन दिस इंसिडेंट मैनी ऑफ द पीपल लॉस देयर लाइफ बिकॉज देर इज ओनली वन एंट्रेंस गेट एंड देर इज नो अनदर गेट सो दैट द पीपल कैन रन आउटसाइड द जलियांवाला बाग. देर इज ओनली वन एंट्रेंस गेट. सो अगेंस्ट द रोलेट एक्ट द पीपल गैदर्ड इन जलियांवाला बाग विच इज इन अमृतसर फॉर द पब्लिक मीटिंग. सो दे ऑल हैव ब्रेक द रूल और यू कैन से लॉ विच इज पास बाय द ब्रिटिश एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एट दैट टाइम. सो इन ऑन 13th April 1919 दिस इंसिडेंट हैपेंड. जनरल डायर अलाउड द सोल्जर्स टू फायर ऑन द crowd which peoples are because in this Jallianwala Bagh many peoples are gathered for the public meeting. So note down the answer. On April 13, 1919, many people gathered on April 13, 1919, many people gathered इन जलियांवाला बाग एंड डू यू नो स्टूडेंट दिस जलियांवाला बाग इज इन अमृतसर. दिस प्लेस इज इन अमृतसर. ओके अमृतसर फॉर ए पब्लिक मीटिंग. फॉर ए पब्लिक मीटिंग ए ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर जनरल डायर विद हिज सोल्जर्स came to the park blocked block its only entrance blocks its only entrance and ordered his soldiers ordered his soldiers to fire at the crowd. Hundred of men, women and children were killed. Hundreds of hundreds of men, women and children were were killed while thousands were injured. This is known as the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So student, what happened on April 13, 1919, many people gathered in Jallianwala Bagh, and where is it, student? It is in Amritsar. And what is the reason behind? The reason for a public meeting. So what's happened, student? A British officer, General Dyer, with his soldiers came to the park, blocked its only entrance and ordered his soldiers to fire at the crowd. So hundred of men, women and children were killed in this incident while thousands were injured, and this is known as the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Is it clear? Thank you, student.